Welcome back. Well, how many of us can say we've fought monsters on battlefields and conjured up spells as a witch and worked alongside Harrison Ford and Michelle Pfeiffer in a thriller?
Yeah, Miranda Otto has done it all, and now she's gearing up for Supernova Comic-Con and gaming. She joins us from Brisbane. Miranda, it's so good to have you with us today. Thank you so much for your time.
Hi, morning. Nice to be here.
It's a pleasure. It's a pleasure. You've played such a diverse array of characters throughout your career. I'm sure it's quite difficult to pick a favourite, but can you please pick a favourite?
Okay. Probably Lord of the Rings. Eowyn in Lord of the Rings is a huge favourite of mine. I love the films. It was such an amazing experience and such a fabulous character to play. But then recently I was on this show, Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, and I was playing a witch, and she was wickedly inappropriate, and it was just such a license to have fun. We had a great time.
You have played so many incredible roles over the years, and one of your latest brings you together with your lovely husband, Peter O'Brien, who was on our show just a couple of weeks ago, actually. He was a lot of fun. What's it been like working with him?
We've worked together a couple of times over the years, and it's always great. Like, I love running ideas by him. Even when we're not working together, I'm always, like, throwing ideas around with him. So it was just really fun. I was so excited when they cast him in the show as well. And I think it was kind of funny for our daughter, though. Like, when some of the scenes in the show were on, we had a viewing, she had to leave the room. It was a little confronting.
You go.
Oh, sorry. No, I was going to say, with Lord of the Rings, I'm such a huge fan of it. I always wondered what it would be like to work through that, like how difficult it would be when you're working around a lot of CGI as opposed to with physical people there.
You know, it wasn't that much CGI on that film. That's what was kind of incredible, is that they did create a lot of that in reality. There were, you know, there were occasional times when I was, you know, acting, looking at a tennis ball or something like that. Which actually worked better than you think it would. But it wasn't a heck of a lot of green screen, not for me at least. There was a little bit of phony pony riding when we weren't actually on a real pony, but just on this sort of barrel on the side of a truck, which was a little embarrassing. But a lot was really actual. Like, you know, Peter Jackson went to great pains to make it very real.
Oh, that scene we're just watching now is one of my favourites. I love it.
What is it about Lord of the Rings and the series that has such devout fans, I guess you could say?
Look, there's people who are huge fans of the book from long ago, and I think that Peter Jackson, you know, stayed really faithful to the ideas behind the book and the characters, and so there's that group of fans. But then there's also the fans who I think just came through the movie. And recently we did this sort of live Zoom with a whole lot of people from Lord of the Rings, and, you know, we were talking about scenes that we'd done. And then there was this great moment at the end where Sean Astin did a piece from Lord of the Rings, and it was just so moving. I think it's the ideals of the book and the film that really grab people, the goodness of it.
You're actually joining the Supernova Comic-Con and gaming, event, which is very, very exciting. It's coming up in Sydney and Perth. What's the vibe like there? I've seen pictures over the years and, wow, the fans get really, really intense. What's it like being there and the object of the fans' affection?
Look, it's a really, really fun event. Like, I am blown away by the costumes and the effort that people put into all of that. Like, they're just amazing costumes. And I think, you know, people enjoy coming to meet us and the writers and exchanging ideas. But, you know, I think they also just enjoy getting together and dressing up and, you know, like, living out their fandom, I think. That's a lot of fun for people. I mean, it's nothing but lovely for me because, you know, I'm sitting there and people come up and tell me about how much, you know, Lord of the Rings means to them. And that's just really lovely. So people are so sweet and people do amazing artworks. And, yeah, it's a lot of fun, a lot of good vibes.
I've seen some fans tattooing the faces of the characters that they go to see on their body parts. Have you had anything strange like that happen to you?
Yeah, I do have some tattoos out there, but I think my tattoos are in Europe, so
Which body part, Miranda, may we ask?
I think there's a calf that has one. I think there's an arm. People have sent me, you know, amazing work, like incredible tattoos. It's like, wow, that would be really hard to do.
Which is a huge honour.
So I hope to see them in person one day, but I think that's more a Europe trip, that one.
How do you get your head around the fact that somewhere in Europe, your face is on someone's calf?
I know. I mean, when people have sent it to me, my best reaction is just like, wow. Like, that's amazing. Like, that's real commitment. That's incredible commitment.
That is great.
And really cool work.
I can't let anyone go without telling me something nice about Harrison Ford. If you could.
He is so sweet and delightful. The funniest thing about Harrison Ford, or my meeting of Harrison Ford, was that I was working on this film, What Lies Beneath, and the lovely producer on that, Jack, was showing me the build of the house that they were building and showing me around. And this guy sort of came past, and he was wearing jeans and like a denim shirt, and he had a cap pulled down. And Jack said, "Oh, this is him." And I kind of missed his name, and I thought, "Oh, he must be like one of the workers who's, you know, building the house here, or someone in the art department." And I was sort of chatting away, and I didn't even realise it was Harrison Ford until after he left, and someone said that was Harrison Ford. It's like, I just didn't catch it because, you know, he had the cap down, and he's so unassuming and delightful. Like, yeah, just one of the guys.
Well, you're not far off. That was his job before he became actor.
Yeah, we'll give him a whip and a hat. Happening. He could have been, you know, Indiana Jones.
Double dipping in there, yeah.
I think he was pretty
interested
to look at the construction of the house, actually. I think that was one of the reasons he was there, that he loves all that stuff. So he was just there, like, you know, fanning it.
He's double dipping, yeah.
Well, you can meet Miranda Otto in person at Supernova Comic-Con and Gaming in Sydney and Perth. Dates and ticket details are on the website, supernova.com.au. Miranda Otto, thank you so much for joining us today.
Cheers. Nice to see you.
You too. Such a pleasure. I love to your family.